rejoicing in hope, patient in tribulations, continuing steadfastly in prayer. Amen.
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 Shall we pray? Shall we pray? Father Divine, we thank you that after all the ages, we are now online, on earth. We commit this worship into your hands. Please attend our prayer session. Let every soul, wherever he or she may be, those at home, those in their offices, wherever tunes into this service, be blessed. We commit the entire program into your hands. We commit pastor into your hands, and let every soul that finds time to listen, enjoy, and have peace. We ask that you bless us, for we ask all this in your Son's name with thanksgiving. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. At this stage, I will invite our pastor, Ebenezer Appiah, the man of God, to take us to the throne of prayer. He is going to lead the prayer session. Thank you.
I greet you all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Welcome to our online prayer meeting. The theme for our prayer meeting is the nations and our nation. The key text is Romans chapter 12, verse 12. Bible says, "Be joyful in hope, patient in afflictions, and faithful in prayer." Let's bow our heads one small time as we pray. Our Heavenly Father, we have come before your presence again as we are going to commit ourselves into prayer. Come in our midst and help us, Lord, to know what we pray for, so that you, Heavenly Father, will answer our prayers and meet our needs. In Jesus' name, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen.
Amen.
In times like these, God has been challenging us to become a praying church. Not just a church that prays, but a church that prays will pray at the beginning, in the middle, and at the end of a worship service. A praying church is a church full of people who pray, not just on Sabbaths, but not just before a beginning of a day also. Not just when a crisis comes up. The church is not a collection of people gathered on the Sabbath morning. The church is a collection of people who are called out, different, and set apart. And we are called out to do something, to accomplish something better together. As prayer moves to the forefront of who we are as a church, we have come online to see God's face in prayer. As we all pray as one voice with one united prayer, God will come down from heaven to see what is happening at our world. Please join us as we pray one more time for nations and our nation affected with this pandemic, that is COVID-19. Philippians chapter 4 verse 6 says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God." before we go into prayer, I want us to sing from the Seventh-day Adventist hymn, hymn 523, 'Tis So Sweet to Trust in Jesus, 524. Verse 4, the psalmist says, "In God whose word I praise, in God I trust and I'm not afraid. What can mere mortals do to me?" Psalm 105 verse 1 says, "Give praise to the Lord, proclaim his name, make known among the nations what he has done." And also Psalm 145 verse 3 says, "Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. His greatness no one can fathom." Lord, as we pray in the midst of this pandemic, we continue to praise the name of the living God, because though people are going through difficulty, nations are suffering, those of us who are alive can praise the name of God.
Amen.
In the midst of this difficult trial. So as we pray together, let's bow our heads and just praise and thank God for what he has done for the past 2-3 months, this pandemic that has hit the entire world. Let's give praise to God. Let's give him glory. Let's give him honor, because God is faithful. He is still sitting on his throne. He has not given up on us. So we have to praise the name of God. Let's bow with me as we pray. Our Father and our God, our King, our Deliverer, we give you praise, we give you honor. We want to thank you for what you have done for us as a word, as we go through difficult moments and trials. You have been faithful to us, though we have lost loved ones, though some of our friends, our family members, been affected with COVID-19, but yet still you are with us. We give you praise, we give you honor, we give you glory.
Amen.
We will give you praise that even in the midst of these nations have come together to find solution. You are giving them wisdom, you are giving them knowledge, you are giving them the spirit of unity to work as human beings. Lord, we give you praise and honor. Even though we cannot assemble as a church to congregate and worship you, you have blessed us with this medium to come together.
Amen.
We give you praise, we give you honor. Lord, you have been faithful. Lord, you have been so grateful unto us. Without you, we are nothing. Without you, this world cannot be sustained. Without you, we cannot be counted among the living, especially our continent, Africa. In spite of the challenges, though we have fewer cases here, not because of our position or our location, is by your grace and protection. Lord, we give you praise and honor. Thank you, God, for an answered prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Let's continue to sing hymn 523, My Faith Has Found a Resting Place. Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. Psalm 145 verse 3 says, praise the God that he is loved. Friends, as we have come to God's throne room of grace, and God's throne room where we can connect with Him. As we have praised the Lord, we also have to come with our sinful hearts and mind and pray that the Lord will be merciful unto us. So we are going to pray a prayer of forgiveness, that we pray that God should forgive the sins of the nations and our nation. We pray that the Lord should be merciful, because what is happening is a human activity. And if you have sinned against God, then also we have to acknowledge and ask God that He should forgive us and cleanse us and make us whole. Psalm 51 says, "Be merciful to me, O God, because of your constant love. Because of your great mercy, wipe away my sins." Verse 2 says, "Wash away all my evil and make me clean from my sin. I recognize my faults and I'm always conscious of my sins. I have sinned against you, only against you, and done what you have considered evil. So you are right in judging me. You are justified in condemning me. I have been evil from the day I was born. From the time I was conceived, I have been sinful. Sincerity and truth are what you require. Fill my mind with your wisdom. Remove my sin and I'll be clean. Wash me and I'll be whiter than snow. Let me hear the sounds of joy and gladness. And though you have crushed me and broken me, I will be happy once again. Close your eyes to my sins and wipe out all my evil. Create a pure heart in me, O God, and put a new and loyal spirit in me. Do not banish me from your presence. Do not take your Holy Spirit away from me. Give me again the joy that comes from your salvation, and make me willing to obey you. Then I will teach sinners your commands, and they will turn back to you. Spare my life, O God, and save me. I will gladly proclaim your righteousness. Help me to speak, Lord, and I'll praise you. You do not want sacrifices, or I will offer them. You are not pleased with burnt offerings. My sacrifice is a humble spirit, O God. You will not reject a humble and repentant heart. O God, be kind to Zion and help her. Rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. Then you'll be pleased with proper sacrifices, and with your burnt offerings and bulls will be sacrificed on the altar." So friends, join with me as we pray that God should forgive our nation, Mother Ghana, should forgive the rest of the nations. And also, we should confess, if we also faulted, we have wronged God, that God should forgive us. Please, bow with me again as we pray. Our Heavenly Father, we agree with the psalmist that we have sinned, Lord. We have fallen short of your glory. As nations, we have turned our back and have done things against your will and against the word of God. We plead and beg of you that, Father, forgive our foolishness. Forgive us our weaknesses. Se boni biara ya ye etiao ya mi huye mobo na fache ya ria started from China ni again sa grobi na ya ta spread throughout the continent. Se si we are say aye din, Lord, have mercy. So we go for na ba ya su ya mi have mercy upon us. Fa ya fun su ni ya a che ne huye mobo o ta fun ni ya na ka unya me we je na wa say no sama say na pandemic we asay ni ebusua na sasi we kura eni hobio. But because of your grace and mercy, because of you, Jesus, who was saviour so for more than epity so na who ye mboni send ye mboni tibia ankronkron and as for my ni yami hu ye mobo na for your full swan yara a chair ne hu ye mobo no my gana mobo. Yari abeye see in your 7 cases, ye ni ya se contacts now among your full fry is more than 350. Ye ni sena we are seneco. Nyami ma bofono emway. A bro we mobi nyami gena fire funsunya che.
Amen.
Na pure be a seny and sakano. nothing and humanity will be saved. Yame yamae. If Jesus said, why am I? When he said, oh, Lord, by Jesus Christ, to be able. Amen. Let's take our hymn once again and sing hymn 300, Rock of Ages. As a nation and other nations and as individuals. Mark chapter 11 verse 17, Jesus began to teach and say to them, is it not written, my house shall be called a house of prayer for all the nations, but you have made it a robber's den. A prayer we are asking that God should pour out his Holy Spirit upon us as a nation, because we need the Holy Spirit directives in terms of how to rule and lead our own lives. If we follow the word of God, some of these pandemics will, or almost even will not experience pandemics at all in our lives. But yes, let's say, Nyame Eda Sotinahingwa Deso. And when we seek the face of God, asking for the power of the Holy Spirit upon the nation as an individual, I know God will hear our prayers and is going to answer as well. So please join with me again. Let us bow as we pray and seek the face of God, asking him to bless us and baptize us with the power of the Holy Spirit. May see it, yes. May I mourn, Pai. Onyami abo osroni asas. Enumre suyasa abawini. Because we need the power of the Holy Ghost. En namun kunkunu su. En ebemun webrade. And among Kunkunusu, any abra wa yelbono ebosomia mini. Abra, the world is shaken by this pandemic, this COVID-19. Yes, says Unyamu Ubehuya Mobo. Please, Lord, have mercy. Don't draw your spirit away from us on this earth. Lord, please baptize us again with the power of the Holy Spirit. Jesus, we plead and beg of you that, Lord, if the Holy Spirit does not come upon us, maybe we'll be experiencing more pestilence than what we're experiencing right now.
So we ask for the power of the Holy Spirit. As Elijah asked Elijah, please, I need the double portion of your Holy Spirit. Father, this is our prayer this evening. Lord, we are mobile. Abra Seventh-day Adventist Church worldwide, here born by Ashes and Yamuba, we are mobile. For whom conquering my head. Say, one poor or moon doing radino. Take this opportunity na hon konkon entry of my being to say yes soon semo kaya no crack na bemuso it yes on musumi rade. It in yami yesel my abra boy is a son a friend queen. Say yam fao serious ma hon konkon emma yam fao serious. Say yam mom pay be bra fit and ma hon konkon why me me mom pay. If we don't study your word, please let your Holy Spirit aid us to study your word. We need the Holy Spirit. As a nation, we need the Holy Spirit. All continents are calling for the Holy Spirit. Please, Lord, come and guide our politicians. Come and guide our leaders so that they can take the right initiatives, so that they will help the various continents or nations to take decisions that will help the people. So, Father, when they're sick, may the Holy Spirit be present.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit speak to their minds and hearts so that they will take right decisions, that heaven will be excited, and we, especially we Christians, and even the entire humanity will say, indeed, the Lord has spoken. Thank you, God, for an answered prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Fire him, Nanibyum. Abraham 2:317, King of my life, I crown thee now.
Amen.
Jeremiah 29:7 says,
seek the welfare of the city where I have sent you into exile, and pray to the Lord on its behalf, for in its welfare you will have welfare. So as Christians, we should pray for our nation. We should seek the welfare of our nation, because if the nation have peace, we also have peace. Because of what is happening to our world and is it affected our country, today we cannot come together as Christians to worship. So it is important to seek the welfare of our nation. Numbers chapter 12 verse 13 says, Moses cried out to the Lord saying, O God, heal her, I pray. As we pray for Mother Earth, that God should heal this continent and also this our world. Numbers chapter 11 verses 1 and 2 says, Now the people became like those who complain of adversity in the hearing of the Lord. And when the Lord heard it, his anger was kindled, and the fire of the Lord burned among them and consumed some of the outskirts of the camp. The people therefore cried out to Moses, and Moses prayed to the Lord, and the fire died out. As the world is in pain, is in crisis, we as Christians, like Moses, we have to pray so that the fire will die out. Amen. So you need to have faith that as Christians, when two or three are gathered in the name of Jesus, God hears our prayers. So the Bible continued to say, but Moses said to the Lord that then the Egyptians will hear of it, for by your strength you brought us up this people from their midst, and they will tell it to the inhabitants of this land. They have heard it that you, O Lord, are in the midst of this people. For you, O Lord, are seen eye to eye. While your cloud stands over them, you go before them in a pillar of cloud by day, in a pillar of fire by night. Now, if you slay these people as one man, then the nations will have heard of your fame and will say, sorry, I missed that. But what Moses is saying that we as Christians, and for that matter, Seventh-day Adventists, I say, Yedima Yemai, Yedima Yasia Yewomu, because ye in your soul, Ochediampo, Yeji Nyan Opundi, in the midst of these difficulties, say, a Christophonia, your bomb pioneer, Sira, they, nay, a tree and room free for Nehua. Onyame ebehuye mmobo na ọdị efunu suo suo debe ache o Kristo ni ye osuo nyame egbojidie mpaya onyame tie na oyesu bebo yesu wa asasi so ni mpaya kwa boy in Luke chapter 23 verse 34 say, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. And they cast for dividing up his garment among themselves. Yesu poa obewu mai abra. Even among four, a young Ayakadian or Bompire, especially a general Evangelion. They said, this is not the time to castigate. This is not the time to judge others. This is the time that we should pray that God should forgive us as people. God should forgive our leaders. That Lord will have mercy upon us. So that what we are experiencing right now, God will speak. So that nyameye aduma ye situation where ye woman ye be free. It in pesi ye bom paye adofo. In pesi ye bom paye se ema ye my God. Not only we should not be selfish. I say ye se ema the various continents, especially Asia, any Europe, any United States of America. Pandemic ye a hate your moha. Let's pray that God will forgive us, and God have a solution to this problem. Because scientists no el bro so, but se nyami ambenwa epi avase ni po ebedi. But ye jidi wosa ye Christo fu anase meme da kwa ye fo ye buji di empire, o nyanku pon tie, lo nyanku pon so ebeyamaye. It will sing 485 from the Seventh-day Adventist hymn. Ye huya, your boat did the empire, said God should have mercy upon us. 485. Mm-hmm.
COVID-19 pandemic way, Yami, and the Yifre,
me a moment, like, just a minute or two, talk to me. Says, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I will trust. Surely he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. He shall cover you with his feathers. And under his wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and buckler. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Only with your eyes shall you look and see the reward of the wicked. Because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place, no evil shall befall you.
Amen.
Nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. He shall give you his angels charge over you, to keep you in all your ways. In their hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. You shall tread upon the lion and the cobra, the young lion and the serpent you shall trample underfoot. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him.
Amen.
I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life I will satisfy him, and show him my salvation. Okay, Psalm 91 is our prayer this evening. We are praying for the nations. We are praying for our world. We are praying for Mother Ghana. We are praying that, Lord, you intercede, and Lord, you step into these waters, these troubled waters. Nyame has said about our job. In Asia, in Europe, in North America, and also northern part of Africa. Yes, listen, Yami, can affect the countries. Yes, about show. Please let your angels descend from heaven. Step into these countries, Lord, and work miracles. Lord, right now we need miracles. We are praying that vaccines will come as soon as possible.
But Lord, be our vassal.
Amen.
Yes, Epovacho. O Biera, O Bodi, Impayosro, O Sufra, O Sayaria, Kenny Yami, Muni Mobono, Yami, yes, so said Muni Mobono.
Amen.
O Yami Yami Edina, and separate families, and separate your mind today. Our mind will be close on the borders because of COVID-19. Nyame yesre epawacho. For how long, na se world yebeko. Yehu se me future, it seems our future is bleak. But nyame ye jibu dino. Nyame ye sufre wo, utie ye sufre na, utie ye Bible, nyame hu ye mobo.
Amen.
Se me ye mno ye ni ye boni tie biya nyame, fa ye fun suwe che.
Amen.
Because of Christians, because of Egidio Fonti, Nyami, Mayena Vasi.
Amen.
Na a hoto any freedom embra. A dear Akosui, a being seen in the history of the world. Say, Yarinti, many of us are in quarantine. Yintimin Kye, Yintimin Ko, Yehudi Yehu. Among one poker moon genia meeting, Ewu said, Uwe Ujwebiyan Kwa. As he is true.
Amen.
It's in Yami Abra, Udi, nature, Ekasa tree, Yami, say who you are, my boy.
Amen.
Nature, Taji, Senebea, Yibinyan and Yarasa, yes, Epawacho. Say, even for a priest of four year marker, it means she will share them also. President, I come 4 weeks, it might even go beyond 4 weeks. But yes, these are signs that are telling us. Signs are the grabber, and this particular sign is telling us, say, you Jesus, your coming is very near. Into a prayer, go and pray as a woman, Ube, we are mobile. Now, I sell my area, please let us remind us that very soon you Jesus will appear in the class of heaven.
Amen.
May we prepare ourselves, Lord. May we meditate on your word. May we spend quality time with you, read your word, speak to our hearts and mind. And let us know that you are God. And beside you, there is no other God. Your word is truth. So please sanctify us by your word. Help us to lift up our souls unto you. Let us take this opportunity to get closer to you than before. As we are battling with this pandemic, Lord, may you have mercy.
Amen.
We pray for those who have lost their loved ones.
Amen.
Lord, may you comfort them.
Amen.
May you, Lord, protect them.
Amen.
They are thinking who will take care of them, but Lord, please be their provider.
Amen.
Lord, those who are on their sickbed, please, Lord, visit them.
Amen.
Let your angels descend and touch them. And make them whole. Lord, we plead and beg of you, visit our nations, the nations all over the continents, and please be merciful to us. We need you more than before. We need you more than before. Come to our aid. Yes, say, why am I never boy? Because the blonde in the human soul is saying, we will be in mercy. But when you are made, you will do not say, okay, dear. Now, why are you for? It's here that was said. So, we see you suffer. When you say, I will not be Jesus Christ to be. Amen.
Amen.
And for Abra, you are so not a baby. We should thank God in the midst of these difficulties. That is what the psalmist says in Psalm 34, verses 1 to 4. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul will make it boast in the Lord. The humble will hear it and rejoice. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from all my fears. Psalm 103, verses 1 to 5 says, bless the Lord, O my soul,
and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget none of his benefit, who pardons all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases, who redeems your life from the pit, who crowns you with the loving kindness and compassion, who satisfy your years with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagle. Amen.
Amen.
As we are almost done with our prayer session, let's continue to be grateful to God that though we are going through a difficult moment, but yet still we are alive. He continued to watch over us. He continued to protect us. He continued to bless us with food, water, shelter, clothing. So let's continue to praise God. As we pray that this pandemic will end, let's continue to be faithful to God. And God will be faithful to us.
Amen.
As we bring this session to a close, let us sing a song of praise, thanking God that he has answered our prayers and will continue to answer our prayers. So we'll sing, Praise My Soul the King of Heaven, hymn number 4. From the Seventh-day Adventist hymn number 4. Then I will pray a prayer of praise and thanksgiving. In the morning and your faithfulness every night on an instrument of 10 strings, on the lute and on the harp, with harmonious sound. For you, O Lord, have made me glad through your work. I will triumph in the works of your hands. O Lord, how great are your works! Your thoughts are very deep. A senseless man does not know, nor does a fool understand this. When the wicked spring up like grass, and when all the workers of iniquity flourish,
It is that they may be destroyed forever. But you, Lord, are on high forevermore. For behold your enemies, O Lord, for behold your enemies shall perish. All the workers of iniquity shall be scattered. But my horn you have exalted like a wild ox. I have been anointed with fresh oil. My eye also has seen my desire on my enemies. My ears hear my desire on the wicked who rise up against me. The righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. He shall grow like a cedar in Lebanon. Those who are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. They shall still bear fruit in old age. They shall be fresh and flourishing to declare that the Lord is upright. Amen. He is my rock, and there is no unrighteousness in him. Amen. Lord, we are grateful unto you that you have come in our midst in times of need. We want to thank you for the prayer of praise. We also want to thank you for the prayer of forgiveness. We want to thank you for pouring out your Holy Spirit upon us. We want to pray that today you are given the privilege to intercede and plead that you, Lord, will have mercy on our world. We also plead and beg of you that, Father, you continue to strengthen us.
Mm-hmm.
Let us build a strong relationship with you. Nature have told us and is still telling us that you are in charge of this world. That when we, O Lord, when we do things against your will, you, Lord, will punish us with pestilence, with diseases that is beyond human reason. But today, thank God that you have spoken to our hearts and mind in prayer, that it is you, O God, who can heal this world, who can heal nations, including ours as well. So as we live, as we plead and beg of you that, Father, you cure us spiritually as well,
amen,
and make us better, so that we will live for you. We know that the signs are telling that you, Jesus, will come very soon. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Bless you too.
For watching and also joining us online. God willing, next Sabbath we'll come again to worship with you. So stay blessed, and God bless you all. Amen.
Amen.